Imagine a criminal whose apartment is being raided by the police, and the only things they've found are a pair of glasses, some books, and a laptop on his desk. After some time, the forensics team is called, and tasked with examining the laptop to uncover every operation that was conducted on it, or look for clues that might link the laptop to other illegal activities. But how will they do that? Well, that's exactly what I'll be covering in this video, and walk you through the different tools or techniques used by investigators in real life, so that you can use this knowledge to enhance your skills or stay sharp, whether you're on the defense side or the attacking one. So let's get started.
Disclaimer.
This video is designed as an entry-level overview of digital forensics, and is not an in-depth tutorial on something specific. The goal of these videos is to provide viewers with a solid understanding of the topic, and clarify key concepts before they dive deeper into the subject.
Chapter number 1, Laptop Forensics.
Okay, so recalling our initial scenario, after the forensics team has arrived, the first step they would take is start bagging the found evidence to ensure its integrity, and establish a chain of custody to keep a track of who handles the evidence. This will keep the evidence from being tampered by anyone, and create a detailed log of how it's examined. Next, the evidence will be taken to a secure lab, where the forensics investigators will assess the state of the laptop, document its condition, and plan the forensics investigation accordingly. For example, if the laptop is switched on and is running the Windows operating system, but the data stored on it is encrypted with a software like VeraCrypt or BitLocker, they may start by performing something called
live memory forensics
on the laptop using a tool like Volatility to try and extract the decryption keys stored on its RAM. However, if the laptop is switched off while being encrypted, they may use forensic imaging tools like the FTK imager to first create a bit-by-bit copy of the laptop's hard drive, and then use multiple techniques to try and break the laptop's encryption, as recovering the decryption keys from its RAM would be impossible in this situation. Now, the reason why I didn't mention bypassing the lock screen of the laptop is because most people already know how easily that can be done by booting the laptop from an external USB drive. However, if the case was such that the criminal kept a password on his BIOS, or blocked unauthorized booting from a USB, the forensic investigators would then have to employ some hardware-level techniques such as removing the CMOS battery of the laptop to reset its settings, or ask the laptop's manufacturer to provide a master password for unlocking the BIOS. After gaining access and decrypting the data stored on hard drives, the investigators will then start examining the file system of the laptop using a tool like Sleuthkit to look for any hidden or deleted files, and if any are found, they will then start recovering them using a tool like the sponsor of this video called EaseUS to uncover the criminal's activity, or look for crucial information. EaseUS is a data recovery software that specializes in retrieving lost or deleted files from various storage devices, including hard disk drives, SSDs, or USB drives. It's known for its user-friendly interface, and a comprehensive scanning process, which can locate files that even some of the best recovery tools might miss, and allows a preview of all the deleted files for free before a person commits to recovering them. Using its advanced recovery options, you can also restore data from multiple devices in different situations, and stay prepared whether you've got a corrupted SD card belonging to a camera, a NAS or Linux device connected to your home or work network, or an unbootable PC crashed due to a virus or a problematic update. Apart from this, I personally like their extended tool called Fixo that uses AI to repair unopened or corrupted files, such as photos, videos or documents, and can be highly useful in situations where you're able to recover a deleted file, but unable to open it due to corruption. So whether you're someone who's looking to restore accidentally deleted files, or an investigator searching for a powerful tool with a 99.7% success rate, you can head over to the EaseUS official website by clicking on the link in the description down below, and exploring their recovery plans available for both Windows and macOS. Thanks for listening, let's get back to the video. Okay, so after examining the file system and gaining complete access to all the data stored on the laptop, the investigators will then start extracting metadata from all the images found within the laptop, and discover information such as when and where they were taken, what camera was used, or if any editing software was applied. This information can be useful in tracing the movement of the suspect, and establishing timelines which might link them to different events. Next, if the investigators want to uncover details about the times or dates the laptop was used in, the applications that were launched, or even detect unusual system activities, they may use a tool like Log Parser or Splunk to first examine all the log files left behind by the applications installed on the laptop, and then use a tool like Reg Ripper to perform registry forensics and discover things like login times, network connections, or modifications to system configurations. Moving on, for tracking the criminal's online behavior and examining all the interactions they engaged in, the investigators may use a tool like History Examiner to first perform forensics on all the browsers found within the laptop, and then use a tool like Mail Examiner to analyze all the emails associated with the accounts logged into these browsers, as that may help in identifying hidden plannings or potential co-conspirators. Finally, to detect and analyze all the external devices that may have been connected to the laptop, investigators can use a tool like USB Deview to list all of them, and retrieve information such as device names, serial numbers, or connection times, which can then help track the movement of data, and uncover additional devices that might contain crucial information. After all these investigative steps are completed, the investigators will then compile a detailed report of all their findings, establish a timeline based on those findings, and draw conclusions relevant to the case. This helps the investigators link certain events to one another, and organize the information in such a way that can be presented to the police or in court.
Chapter number 2, Smartphone Forensics.
Okay, so taking the same scenario as before, if the police found a smartphone instead of a laptop, and asked the forensics team to examine all the operations that were conducted on it, they would follow similar steps as they did for the laptop. However, the only differences would lie in the forensic tools being used, and some additional steps due to the nature of the smartphones, as they are primarily used for communication and personal activities, rather than general computing or data storage. This approach also applies to other digital devices like cameras, drones, or smartwatches, with some minor differences due to their nature and hardware used. However, if you're interested in learning more, I encourage you to search for them on the internet and explore multiple articles yourself.
Chapter number 3, Malware Forensics.
Finally, a forensic investigator doesn't always work with law enforcement agencies to help investigate a crime, but can also work with private companies to help investigate a security breach or a cyber attack. This can be done by either analyzing the log files of a system to determine how it was hacked, or placing a malware in a secure environment to see how it operates. Now, if you're interested in learning more, you can go ahead and watch these videos that I recently created by clicking on the I button above, but nonetheless, this field is usually referred to as DFIR or threat intelligence in the cybersecurity community, and here the forensic investigators not only help investigate a cybercrime, but also take necessary measures to help prevent a future attack. Anyway guys, so that's it for the video. If you have any questions, feel free to comment in the comment section down below, and I'll see you in the next one.